swung hard, hit deep in the air to left center field. Left fielder looking up. This ball is gone. A home run. Weinstein's and deals. Pitch called to strike. Swing and a fly ball to left field. Pitch. Ball game is tied. Fine, he gets the job done. To the backstop. And now he's going to go to second. Now the time goes in the right field.
You know, defensively, Mike Affronti and Sean McGill have done a great job at shortstop and catching, respectively.
Fog here, it brings a tear to my eye, or maybe that's just the humidity. Anyhow, Nick,
That's in there, called third strike. Swing and a miss, strike three. In time, he got him.
Double play on that one.
So, a strike him out, throw him out, double play.
Be heating up a little.
Perhaps if the score 8-4.
Might be seeing a bench-clearing brawl one of these.
The 1-0. Swing and a drive, deep to left field. Way back. He's being waved home.
Oh my goodness, that's a great catch if I ever saw one.
On the first double play. That is, look out, and the Gulls lead it 10-1. And here's the throw to the plate. He got him in time. Gulls come into this game leading the NECBL Southern Division.
There's a ground ball. That one is balls in for a hit. Of course, this is baseball, as we know. Anything can happen, and it's not over till it's over.
He's ready now. The 1-2 pitch. Sets, kicks, and deals. Swing and a miss, strike three. And this ball game is over. That's the second out there on the first double play. What a catch. 1-1 will score. Here's the throw to the plate. It is not in time.
And looks like they're trying the suicide squeeze, and it works.
At a deep left field. Way back. Way back. Send that ball to the light tower. A high fly ball. Deep to left field. Way back. Swing a shot. Deep to left field. Swing and a high fly ball. Deep to center field. Way back. Home run. 3-run homer. Shortstop has it. Puts the second out there. The first double play. Here comes Locke. He will score. Swing and a line drive. Base hit to left field. Standing. Standing. Running first. Running second. On the way to third. Here's the throw to the plate. It is nine and times.
Swing and he strikes him out.
Here's the 0-2. Swing and a miss. Strike three. Call third strike. Swing and a miss. Strike three.
Swing and a miss.
Swing and a miss. Strike three. So long, everybody. Hello, everybody. Welcome here tonight to Cardines Field in Newport, Rhode Island, where this evening our Newport Gulls will be taking on the Danbury Westerners in an outstanding baseball matchup. Coming to this game tonight, the Newport Gulls have a 6-3 record. The Danbury Westerners are 5-2. They're 1-1 away playing an away game here tonight at Newport, their first of three games this season to be played at Cardines Field. The Gulls have one more game to play at Danbury. They'll be playing that later on this season as well. They played two just this past Tuesday. You may have heard yours truly, Nick Lima, on the internet broadcast as I broadcast their away game live along with Frank Yocker from the Danbury Westerners organization internet broadcaster. Those two teams will be vying tonight. Each team is tied for first in the NECBL Southern Division. Very close race in the Southern Division. The Newport Gulls, of course, were out to a 6-0 record before dropping those two games to Danbury. Danbury really has a very tough team this year. Mike Tosse, who pitched all 11 innings of a two-night, 11-inning, extra-inning game against the Newport Gulls. Tosse gets the start tonight here at Cardines Field for the Westerners. Tosse only gave up two runs and got the win in that game. For the Newport Gulls, it's Jeremy Hall on the mound tonight. A great pitching matchup, a great matchup overall. We'll have plenty of baseball action as the starting lineups next continue here on the Newport Gulls Television Network. Once again, Cardinals Field in Newport, starting lineups for the visiting Danbury Westerners. We'll see if our camera guy can get a shot of the Danbury Westerners. Leading off for the Westerners will be the center fielder, Randy Ray. Jose Ortiz, the first baseman, bats second. Joe Malacone, the catcher, bats third. There's Westerners on your screen right there. In cleanup tonight for Danbury will be Ryan Mahoney. Mahoney's the designated hitter. Batting fifth, Michael DeLuca, the shortstop. In the sixth spot is Brian Mailer, the left fielder. The third baseman bats seventh, John Bellis. And batting eighth is Jeff Vincent, the right fielder. Rounding out the order for the Danbury Westerners is Matt Teal. He's the second baseman. Their starting pitcher tonight is Mike Tossey. Tossey, left-handed pitcher out of the University of Connecticut. His hometown is actually Danbury, Connecticut. Tossey is 6'8", 181 pounds, very tall up there on the mound. He, of course, pitched all 11 innings against all of his 11 innings of the season so far against Newport in that 11-inning, extra-inning game, which took place on two nights. It was last Saturday and wrapped up on Tuesday of this week. Tonight, of course, is June 17th, 2005. Great baseball action coming up shortly. In that game against Newport in 11 innings, he gave up five hits and two earned runs. The head coach for the Westerners is Rusty Gosselin, and their assistant pitching coach is Kevin Long. For the home Newport Gulls, the Gulls coming in this game are 4-0 at home, 6-2 overall. Jeff Miller gets the leadoff spot tonight. Miller, in his first tries at the leadoff, now he's now joined the Newport Gulls. He's just been activated recently. Miller's a second baseman. Michael Farney bats second, the shortstop. Farney back for a second season with the Gulls. Zach Clem's the left fielder. He bats third. Sean McGill in cleanup batting fourth. Sean McGill is, of course, the catcher, also back for a second season. Batting fifth is Blake Church. Church, first baseman. After Church, we'll see Scott Brown, the right fielder. Brian Jaroszynski is the DH tonight, batting seventh, and batting eighth is Warren Schaefer, the third baseman. And running at the order for the home Newport Gulls is Nick Burnham. Burnham, the center fielder. Starting pitcher tonight for Newport is Jeremy Hall. Hall, a right-handed pitcher out of East Tennessee State University. 6'4", 395 pounds, looking for another win tonight. The coaches for the Newport Gulls, now the manager officially is Mike Coombs, while in Josh Scott and Monty Smith. Let's pause for the national anthem. How about that national anthem played here tonight at Cardinals Field? Very good crowd on hand already. It's a Friday night baseball here in downtown Newport. A great game ahead. As I was saying, Tommy Atkinson may no longer be the manager for the rest of the season. Mike Coombs will be filling in for him as Atkinson has taken the head coaching job at Lewisburg College. Has to do some recruiting and get back to his job there. So it'll probably be Mike Coombs, formerly of the Milwaukee Brewers organization. Try to say that five times fast. So Mike Coombs may be the acting manager for the rest of the season. He's assisted by Josh Scott and Marty Smith. Well, great temperature right now. It's about 74 degrees under partly cloudy skies, 40% relative humidity. Very comfortable night for baseball. Pretty gusty wind, as you saw the shot of the American flag there. About westerly wind, 10 to 15 miles per hour, gusting into the 20s. Possible thunderstorms later on this evening. Hopefully, they'll stay away from Cardine's Field. The Newport Gulls and Danbury Westerners vie for sole possession of first place in the NECBL Southern Division next as we continue on the second season of the Newport Gulls Television Network. First pitch is next. Here now at Cardine's Field, first pitch of the ball game from Jeremy Hall is outside. Ball one, the count's 1-0. Hall coming into this game has a 6.75 ERA, he's 0-1. The pitch, swing and a hot hit ground ball right to first baseman. He'll have it and take it 3-0 for the inning's first out. As I rearrange my scorecard, Randy Ray is retired. Ray retired here on two pitches. So here comes Ortiz, Jose Ortiz, first baseman for the Danbury Westerners. Ortiz leading, or rather in second place in the Westerners with a 417 batting average at this young point in the season. The Westerners have played seven games, at 5-2 overall, 1-1 on the road. The pitch is in there for a called strike. The count's 0-1 to Ortiz. Ortiz does have one home run. Jeremy Hall lines, kicks and deals. On the outside corner, the called strike. Just got the names of the umpires, folks. Calling balls and strikes at the plate is Pete Smith. Around the bases, it's local resident John Leeds. Here's the next delivery. Swinging a foul off the screen, and the count remains 0-2. One out here in the top of the first inning. Sean McGill needs to grab an extra game ball. Hall with the next delivery. Just missed on the outside corner, and the count is now 1-2. Ortiz levels the bat, he's ready. Hall looks in, lines and deals. Swing and a high fly ball to left field deep. Left fielder coming on now as the wind knocks it down, makes the catch for the inning second out. Two up, two down. Here comes Malacone. John Malacone is leading the Danbury Westerners with a 421 batting average. He's also leading the team with five runs batted in, as and is tied for first with two home runs. Of course, the Westerners play in one of the smallest ballparks in the NECBL at Rogers Park in Danbury, Connecticut. It's only about 355 feet to the center field wall out there. The pitch. Up and inside, ball one, it's 1-0. Jeremy Hall looks in, working quickly in the first. The next pitch is in the dirt, blocked by the catcher McGill. Ball one, defense, or rather ball two, defense for the Newport Gulls. It's Church at first, Miller at second, fronting the shortstop, Schaefer at third, McGill the catcher. In left, it's Clem, center and Burnham, and right field is Brown. The pitch, swinging a foul off the netting just above the screen. And the count is 1-1. Two outs here in the top of the first inning. Hall looking for a 1-2-3 inning to start off the night. Coming to this game tonight, Danbury and the Newport Gulls are tied for first in the NECBL Southern Division. His next delivery is swung on, hit in the air to right field, not very deep, and foul now and out of play. Westerly wind blowing in variable directions across the ballpark. Likely keep most balls in the outfield tonight. Might not see too many home runs. Steady ocean breeze here, about a block from the water. Downtown Newport. Hall looks in for the sign. He's ready now. Winds, kicks and deals. Just missed in the outside corner. Very good off-speed pitch. And the count is full, 3-2. Once again, Hall looks in. Malacone. Waits the payoff pitch. Swing and a high fly ball to the left field. This one may be fading foul now. Lands it for a base hit. about 2 feet to the right of the foul line. Malika Rani first, he'll be on the second. Slides in now with a two-out double. Well, folks, look like the wind was going to keep blowing that out into the bullpen in foul territory. However, it got knocked down out there. I think it sort of scared the left fielder, Clem. He wasn't expecting that to drop like that, but it did drop. And just like that, the Westerners have their first man in scoring position with two outs here in the first. Here comes Ryan Mahoney, designated hitter. He has no batting average to report thus far. Mahoney awaits the pitch with a runner at second. Ball fires, and it's outside ball one. Mahoney has only appeared in one game. He did not make that start. This is his first start of the season. The next pitch from Hall. Swinging a foul around the netting. This is only our second game tonight, calling the game from the backstop area. Notice our camera position is a little bit bright there. We'll correct that in the next half of an inning. All-volunteer crew, the Tigers TV crew, the Newport Goals Television Network, to bring these games to you. Every Newport Goals home game of the 2005 season, we'll try to commit to you. The Hall's next delivery is hit in the air to left field. Left fielder Clem lining up, makes the catch. One-handed for the out, three ties aside. And the Westerners strand a runner at second. We played half an inning here at Cardinals Field in Newport. It's the Westerners nothing. The goal's coming up here on the Newport Goals Television Network. Once again, Cardinals Field in Newport. So we head to the last half of the first inning. Jeff Miller is first official at bat for the Newport Gulls here in a Gulls uniform in the 2005 season. Waits the pitch. And it's on the inside corner. Called strike. The count's even at 1-1. Is the pitcher pitching to him is Mike Tossie. Tossie stands very tall amount, 6'8". His next delivery is missing low. Fastball and it counts 2-1. Tossie does have a little bit of an awkward delivery there as he flicks his wrist. He's a left-handed pitcher. His next delivery is swung on in the air to right field, but foul and out of play. 2-2 the count to Miller. Jeff Miller, second baseman for the Newport Gulls. It was eligible to play as of yesterday. Of course, yesterday was the Gulls' first off day in nine straight games since the season started on Tuesday, June 7th. Tossie's next pitch is outside. Ball three, and the count is full. After Miller, we'll see Affronti and Clem. Tossie from, well, rather, winds and deals. Swinging a weak hit ground ball chopper. Third baseman has it on a hop. Fires the first. In time, he got him. So Miller retired. He's now 0-1 on the season. Here comes Michael Affronti. Affronti returning for his second season in a Gulls uniform. Affronti plays for the Dolphins. He's batting .333 with one home run. That home run came on Tuesday in Danbury. There's the starting pitcher right there, number 31. Mike Tossie. Tossie has a 2.57 ERA, struck out 5, walked 3. He's gonna have 2 earned runs. 5 hits. The pitch is in there for a called strike. Tossie started one game against Newport, and he has no record. Next pitch. Missing low with the ball. Affronti awaits a pitch from Tossie. Here it is. Just missed in the outside corner at the knees. And the count is, it's 1-2 according to the scoreboard. I'll trust that. So that pitch must have been a strike earlier. Tossie working quickly with the 1-2 pitch. Swing and another ground ball chopper right in the same place. Shortstop this time has it. Fires the first. Got him by a step. Affronti thought he was safe. And disappointed, heads back to the dugout. So 2 ground outs, 1-5-3, 1-6-3. Here comes Zach Clem. Clem, left fielder for the Newport Gulls, like Miller. He's just been activated, returned from the playoffs and the college games. Super regionals, I believe they call them. Dossie, again, 6 foot eight, standing very tall on the mound, the pitch. Outside is catcher John Malacoon, got crossed up. Defense for the Westerners, that's Jose Ortiz at first, Matt Teal at second, Michael DeLuca the shortstop, John Bellis at third, it's Mailer on left, Randy Ray in center, and Jeff Vincent in right. Tossie with the 1-0 pitch. Swing and a looper in the left field. That ball will fall for hit. It'll go all the way to the wall. Clem rounding first, on the way to second. Here's the throw. It is cut off and not in time. John Leeds says he's safe. It's cut off by the shortstop, DeLuca, who had a quick toss to Teal at second, and John Leeds said he was safe. So, Zach Clem in his first at bat in a Gulls uniform has a double. And the Newport Gulls, like the Westerners in the top of the inning, have a runner in scoring position with two down. Here comes Sean McGill. McGill back for his second season here at Cardinals Field. His first at bat in opening night, can't mention it enough, he hit a three-run homer. And his first at bat back here at Cardinals last Tuesday. Tonight's Friday, June 17, 2005. The pitch with the runner at second is outside ball one. So Zach Clem, not batting 1.000 on the season with a double. Clem hoping to be sent around here on a base hit by McGill. Tossie worrying about Clem. The pitch. That's on the outside corner. The call strike this count, and the count's even at 1-1. Sean McGill is batting 243. He has three doubles, leading the goals in doubles thus far in the season. He's made a start in every game for Newport. His first two starts were in left field as the goals were short and outfielder then. The pitch is hit on the ground. The shortstop has it. Fies a long way to first and got him in time. The goals strand Clem on base at second. We've played one full here at Cardinals Field. No scores and continue on the Newport Gulls Television Network. Field. Important to go to the top of the second inning. Mike DeLuca. DeLuca is a shortstop for the team. The pitch is inside. Did that hit him? But DeLuca thought it did. He just fouled off. So counts 0-1 to him. DeLuca batting 250 coming into the game tonight. DeLuca awaits the pitch. Here it is. Oh, outside. Ball. One of the counts 1-1. The next delivery from Jeremy Hall. Swing and a foul right off the pole that holds up the netting. That's a 1-in-a-million shot. And he's in the hole now, 1-2. Jeremy Hall, starting pitcher tonight for Newport. Hall has made three appearances, one start. Ball winds and deals. Outside ball two, counts even at 2-2. Hall has pitched 6.2 innings, given up 10 hits, 6 runs, 5 of them earned. He's walked 4, struck out 2, given up 2 doubles, no home runs. He's faced 27 at batters prior to the game tonight. The pitch is a call, third strike, first strikeout of the evening for either team. That means a Gulls friend gets a free t-shirt here tonight too. So Hall has his first strikeout as DeLuca fans looking. Here comes Brian Mailer. Mailer, left fielder for the Westerners, batting just 133 thus far this season. Mailer stands in from the left side of the plate, waits a pitch from Hall. Here it is. On the outside corner, the call strike, counts 0-1. Brian Mailer waits the next pitch, and that's a called strike again. Mailer didn't like it. I didn't really see the location there. Looked very outside, but it's strike two nonetheless. Here's the 0-2 from Hall. Wild pitch goes to the backstop. That one got away from him. That was way out. That one was definitely outside. And it counts 1-2. No runners on, so it matters not. Mailer awaits the 1-2 pitch. swinging another foul to the backstop at the same location. Lucky, thankful to have our backstop camera back in place tonight. We had a short crew on Monday, so we just did a one camera game for you. We had all three home games of the opening week for the Newport Gulls in the NECBL here at Cardines. Here with our fifth production of the season tonight. That pitch is in the air to left field. Left fielder coming on and can't get it as it's foul and into the bullpen. Clem decided to chase after that one, but it was out of play. Not exactly the best location to call a game back here. We have fans walking in front of me, and pretty ominous fence in front of me. However, I did have the poles back in the right field broadcast booth, so we'll work with what we have. Supposed to have a table built for us. Well, still waiting for that. I'm using my own table right now. If it falls down, well, we're done for. The pitch. That's hitting the air in the same place. Foul up the left field line. So we're here behind the backstop for our second game. Did all three games the first week for you up in the right field broadcast booth, which we were at all last season and the 12 games we did from there. The pitch. Outside. Ball two in the counts, even at 2-2. Jeremy Hall looking for his first win of the season. Hall winds and deals. Missing low and inside with the ball. The count is full 3-2. Mailer, left fielder for the Westerners, who are tied for first with the Gulls in the NECBL Southern Division. Ball needed a moment, stepped off, now back on the mound. Throws the rubber. The payoff pitch. Swing and a high fly ball to center field, but not very deep. Center fielder coming on and calls for it, makes the catch. And that's the inning second out. Burnham in center field tonight for Newport. Jim Murphy not in the lineup this evening. Neither is Stephen Douglas. Douglas has a .293 batting average. Murphy has a .353 batting average. Douglas has made all nine starts for the Newport Gulls to date. Neither player is in the lineup tonight for Newport, so it's Burnham and not Douglas in center field for Newport this evening. The pitch to the right-handed batter is swung on and missed strike one. That batter is Bellis. John Bellis, third baseman for the Westerns, batting .059 on the season. His next delivery is swung on, grounded foul up the third base line. Bellis thus far has played in seven games, made four starts at third. Bellis has scored two runs, just one hit in the pitch. Swinging, there's a new grounder right there, Friday. He has it, fires to first. In time, they got him, a 1-2-3 inning for Jeremy Hall, the Newport Gulls. We go to the home half, the second. Still no score here on the Newport Gulls Television Network. It's Newport Daily News and Little League night here at Cardines Field. The Daily News sponsoring tonight's game, and all Little Leaguers in uniform got in for free tonight. They didn't have to pay admission. We're here now in the last half of the second inning. Other action around the league today. Keene's at Lowell, 6:30 start time underway now. Of course, Danbury here at Newport, 6:35. This game got underway right on time. Pittsfield's Dukes are at North Adams. 7 o'clock start time there. Going to be underway shortly. It's almost 7 now. Concord's at Sanford, 7 o'clock. Also 7 o'clock games. Vermont at Holyoke. And the Manchester Silkworms are playing the Torrington Twisters. Torrington, of course, is last place in the Southern Division right now. Danbury and Newport tied for first. Danbury 5-2 and Newport 6-3. North Adams is 3-3 in third place, a game and a half back. Two games back is Manchester and three games back is Pittsfield. Torrington is 3.5 games back there, 1-5 in the season. The pitch is ground to the shortstop. He fires the first wide, and it gets away. He couldn't hold on to the ball, and Church is on. That'll be an error, maybe a throwing error to the shortstop. The throw is very wide. I don't think the first baseman, Jose Ortiz, had much of a chance to hold on to that ball. It was in and out of his glove as he had to leap in the air. So we'll call that an E6. We'll see the official scorer's interpretation later on. So here comes Scott Brown. Brown gets a home crowd cheer. Brown tends URI. Brown's actually a native of Maine, though. The pitch. Outside ball one. I could be wrong in that. I know there are two or three goals from the URI. I believe Brown is the Maine resident. I'll double check on that later for you folks. The next pitch. That's missing inside with a very fast fastball, probably around 90 miles per hour. And the count is 2-0. It'll be Brown, Jarosinski, and Schaefer due up next with Church at first. Mike Tosse with the 2-0 pitch. On the outside corner, a called strike. Plate umpire Pete Smith is really giving that outside corner to the pitchers tonight. Not so much on the inside, though. Tosse from the set and throws in the first, and the runner Church back standing. Last night, Gold Squads had their first night off in 9 games since the season opened. Keene defeats Sanford 2-1. Keene is off to a great start. They've had 5 straight wins. They're 6-1 now, leading the Northern Division. That pitch is on the ground, right to the shortstop. 5 seconds out there on the first. Double play. So just like that, Church is erased as Brown grounds into a 6-4-3 double play. Here comes Jarosinski now, batting with 2 outs and the bases empty. Brian Jarosinski is at the DH tonight for Newport. Jarosinski has also served as a right fielder for the team. Jarosinski, batting just 133, is in a slump as of late. Awaits the pitch from Mike Tosse. Here it is. On the outside corner again, the called strike. That one looked a little outside to me, but Pete Smith really is giving that outside corner to these pitchers. He's entitled to do as he sees fit. The pitch, that's it, that was in there. Clip the outside corner, and the count's 0-2 to Jarosinski. Mike Tosse has made 3 appearances, 1 start. Giving up 5 hits, 6 hits now, thanks to the double by Clem earlier. Tosse with the 0-2 pitch. Swinging a looper in the left field. That'll fall for it. It's 7 hits now as Jarosinski's rounding first. He'll be sent into second as the ball goes into the bullpen for a ground rule double. There was a little roller that bounced over the third baseman's head and went up the foul line into the bullpen. And once it does that, the ball's out of play. So Jarosinski stands in at second for the second inning in a row. The Gulls have a runner in second with 2 outs. Here comes Warren Schaefer. Schaefer, batting 121, third baseman for the Gulls. Runner at second. The pitch, swing and a miss, strike one. Schaefer chased the fastball up high. It's very late on the swing as well. Couldn't catch up. Schaefer has one of the lower averages on the Gulls team. Waits a pitch from Tosse. That swung on a missed strike two. Chased the curve outside. And Schaefer's in a hole 0-2. Jarosinski stands in at second. 2 outs here in the last half of the second inning. Mike Tosse comes to the set and to the plate. Outside, ball one, wants to pitch out. No one covering at second, the count's 1-2. Once again, Tosse from the set, the 1-2 pitch. Outside again, ball two, and the count's even at 2-2. Very good sized crowd here tonight, Cardinals Field. Maybe a sellout, maybe the first sellout of the season. I haven't seen a crowd this large here at Cardinals Field since the championship game last year where we had over 3,000. It was a crowd of 2,000 on the game on second night of the season here at Cardinals, Military Appreciation Night. That's a ground ball by the third baseman, is over his head. And Jarosinski running third, he'll be held up there. And Warren Schaefer breaks out of his slump with a single. That was a very hard hit chopper. Bounced maybe twice before hit, getting to the third baseman, John Bellis. Bellis couldn't feel it. It was in and out of his glove and went over right over his head and the left center in the left field, up the line. So now the goals have runners at the corners of two outs. The first potential runner is 90 feet from the plate. Jaron Siski at third. Schaefer at first for the number nine man, Nick Burnham. Burnham is batting an even 250. Burnham, center fielder for tonight for Newport, filling in for Douglas. Tossie in a jam here with two outs. Runners at the corners, the pitch. On the outside corner, the called strike, the count's 0-1. Scoreboard catches up. They had 3-0 up on the board. No score here in the last half of the second inning. Once again, Tossie with the pitch. Outside, low ball one. The count's even at 1-1. 1-1. I don't know what the apiece would mean. Anyway, very pleasant night here in Newport. Runners at the corners as I drop my pen. Uh-oh. Don't worry, folks, I have a backup. It is an $8 pin, though. Look, runners at the corners, the pitch is a ground ball over the pitcher's head. This may be trouble, but not quite, as the shortstop really had to range to his right and made the play, snagging the ball and stepping in the bag at second. For the other, he ties the side. A goal, strand runners at the corners. We've played two full here at Cardines Field. Still no score here in the Newport Goals Television Network. Well, back here at Cardines Field, what happened to our bumper music there, Tom?
Well, we have some problems with the laptop over here. It seems to have, it's frozen right now.
All right, well, we'll work on that. That pitch is hitting the end of left field. Left fielder coming on, makes a great diving catch. I don't know if the camera caught that. Maybe the graphic may have been in the way, but left fielder for the Newport Goals, Zach Clem, in his first night in Goals uniform, just came on hard to make a great diving catch to retire Vincent. So that's Jeff Vincent retired there on the put out by Zach Clem. So just like that, one down on one pitch. Here comes the number nine man, Matt Teal. My brother, an audio technician, Tom Lima, works on our audio problem. The pitch, swing and a foul, look out, right towards us. Almost fell on my seat on Monday night. And a foul ball came right to me, of course. The screen blocked it, but I'm not used to that, folks. Used to sit up in the right field press box here tonight behind the plate area. Very precariously perched here too. Table's not being held down or anything. It's on the bleachers. The pitch, swinging a foul up, back and out of play on American Scup Avenue right in the intersection behind us. And quickly, Teal in a hole now, 0-2. Jeremy Hall. Working with the bases empty, one out here in the top of the third. The pitch is swung on, chopper. Baltimore hop to the shortstop, Franny, and made a great play at first. So Franny showing his arm off there again tonight. Franny came from the shortstop position to grab that one and fired the first. So just like that, there are two men out. And we cycle around to the top of the order. And Randy Ray. Ray grounded out his last time up. Randy Ray is batting 208. He has two home runs. Center fielder for the Danbury Westerners. The pitch to Ray is inside ball one. If you're wondering why our camera position shakes there, folks, it's precariously perched halfway up a chain link fence that serves as a screen behind the backstop. Is the next delivery. It's way up high inside, almost at the neck level. It counts 2-0. And as the kids walk by that fence on the opposite side of it, crossing from one side of the park to the other, they tend to hold on to the fence and that shakes it. And therefore, our camera position, which is attached to the fence, shakes. The 2-0 pitch. That's on the outside corner. Pretty good pitch from Hall. It counts 2-1. So nothing we can do about that shaky camera for you, but At least we have a camera position there. We don't have the technology to give you the outfield camera that zooms in on the back of the pitcher like the professional outlets do, but we do what we can for you here on the NGTN. Time's called as the batter, Ray, one more time. He's ready now. Hall winds and deals. On the outside corner, the call strike counts even at 2-2. Two in down here in the top of third, still no score. Dan Barry in Newport played an 11-inning game that started last Saturday night, finished up on Tuesday afternoon. The 2-2, swinging a ground ball right to third baseman. He has it, goes a long way to first in time and got him. Another 1-2-3 inning for the Newport Gulls. And I'll tell you about that game that happened there on Tuesday night, which I happened to attend in Western Connecticut. Well, the Newport Gulls and the Danbury Westerners started that game in the 11th inning. It was halted at the end of the 10th on Saturday night, and in the 11th, it was started up again on Tuesday. Of course, that game was halted at 11 o'clock on that Saturday night. Well, on Tuesday, they started in the 11th, tied at 2 apiece. Franny came up, hit a solo home run at Danbury, and the Gulls took the lead 3-2. Then in the bottom of the 11th inning, the Westerners lowered the bases, got a run home, and tied the score 3-3. Then they were out of position players, so the pitcher, normally the designated hitter, had to come up to bat with the bases loaded and two outs. And wouldn't you know it, suicide squeeze, a runner got home, and with a walk-off suicide squeeze, the Westerners won the game. That was the Gulls' first loss of the season. They later lost the second game that night. 7-5, the final score on that one. The Gulls got up to a 5-0 deficit and later tied the score 5-5. They gave up 4 home runs in that game, which accounted for all 7 runs. Or rather, 5 of the runs, I should say, by the Westerners. So those were their only 2 losses this season. And that's your season wrap-up here by, from the Newport Gulls. The Newport Gulls are 6-2 overall now, hoping to break ahead of the Danbury Westerners, who they're tied for first with in the NECBL Southern Division. Well, we played 2.5 here at Cardines Field. Still no score. The Gulls looking to get ahead of Danbury tonight as we continue on the Newport Gulls Television Network. Miller here to lead things off for the Newport Gulls as we go to the home half of the third inning. Miller awaits a pitch. Here it is. And it's on the outside corner, a called strike. Jeff Miller in his first game in a Gulls uniform. Miller, second baseman for Newport, eligible to play for the first time tonight. The pitch, swinging on another ground ball chopper. This time the shortstop has it, fires the first. In time, got him by a half a step. So Miller retired on 2 pitches, 6-3. Here comes Michael Affronti. Affronti grounded out 6-3 his last time up. Well, I think it's becoming apparent that Mike Tossi is a ground out pitcher. Let's see, we have 6 ground outs thus far on the evening. Pitch to Affronti is outside, ball 1, the count's 1-0. Michael Affronti coming into the game tonight had a .333 batting average with 1 home run, which came versus the Westerners. Affronti waits the pitch, swing and a miss, strike 1, and the count's 1-1. Affronti leading not only the Gulls but the entire NECBL with 14 hits. Franny started every game at shortstop for the Gulls. Here's the 1-1 from Tossi. Tempted bunny squared and the pitch was outside. However, the bat crossed the plate, counts 1-2. One man down here in the last half of the third inning. Michael Tossi, 6'8", 185 pounds. His 1-2 delivery. Outside ball 2, the count's even at 2-2. Tossi, once again, working quickly. 1-1, and now deals to Affronti. Swinging a ground ball off of his glove. Second baseman boots it, and Affronti's on at first. Booted it, went into right field. Shortstop went in to get it. So Fronte holds up at first, and once again, Newport Gulls have a base runner and are threatening here with just one out in the third inning. We'll charge that likely as an error on the second baseman. It's a replay, and Fronte, of course, in at first. I don't think we did catch it as the ball went to left field. It was a great bloop hit over the pitcher, and you saw him, he did get a glove on it. That's our first instant replay of the season, our Newport Gulls instant replay. Think of a better name for it later. Runner at first, and Fronte dives back in. As we lose the audio signal there, what's happening, Tom? That was strange. We had a loose connection. You fix that laptop yet, Tom? Oh, everything's all set. So my audio technician and brother Tom Lima's fixed everything. The pitch. Outside, ball one. Still sounds a little bit shaky there, Tom. I hear some, I don't know, what kind of shoddy connection this is. May sound fine, the tape, folks, though. Maybe that's just my headset. Is it my headset? Yes, it is. Yes, it is. Okay. Runner at first, the 1-0 pitch. Swing and a foul to right, up the right field line. Now it's fading fair. Right fielder makes the catch. And if Fronte's in the third, or did he? He couldn't make the catch. Well, we couldn't see that, folks. At least I couldn't from up here. And if Fronte's in at third, so Zach Clem is 2-for-2 tonight as Clem stands in at first. So Fronte advanced to third by Clem's single to right field. That ball landed probably a foot in front of the right fielder, Jeff Vincent. So the brief conference out on the mound right now between John Molicone, the catcher, and Tosse. Tosse in a jam here, one out, runners at the corners. No score. Home half of the third. Sean McGill. Chance to be the hero here. Tosse looks in. Checks Zach Clem at first. The pitch. Outside, ball one, it's 1-0. Sean McGill grounded out to the shortstop is the last time up. So it's Clem who singled at first, and Fronte reached on error by the second baseman at third. Tosse with the pitch, a runner goes, swing and a miss, and may have been fouled. It was fouled around the plate area. So Clem, who had second base stolen, retreats back to first. 1-1 the count to Sean McGill. Outstanding crowd here on an outstanding evening here at Cardines Field. A little bit cool for mid-June. Flags blowing out to right field. Steady wind. Maybe about 66 degrees, I'm guesstimating, folks. Runners at the corners. And now I'll throw back to first, and standing is Clem. Still just one out. 1-1 the count to Sean McGill. Tosse from the set. The pitch, and instead another throw to first, and he may be caught in a run down here. The throw goes back to second. They try it, and now the runner at third is caught. Here's the throw. And he dives back. Here's another play. He's caught up there. He's back again. Back to the catcher. Back to the pitcher, and he's finally tagged out and surrenders. And on the play, Clem advanced all the way to third. Well, the entire infield, about six or so Westerners, had to come in to make that play. Don't ask me what the score was on that. Well, I have to get the official score. It's probably something like 2-4-5-3-6-4-5-6 or something of that nature. And like that, just like that, there are two men out in the inning. It was Clem who was caught between first and second as they tried a squeeze play to get the runner at third home. And it did not happen. So Clem's now at third. Fronte tagged out. Fronte, a soldier, went back and forth about five times before finally surrendering, realizing that Clem was at third. So with two men out, Sean McGill remains the batter, and still accounts just 1-1 on him. Tosse with worrying about Clem at third. The 1-1 pitch to McGill. Swing and a drive to right center field. This ball is caught by the center fielder as the right fielder came on to back him up, and that'll do it for the Gulls here in the third inning. We go to the fourth. Still no score here on the Newport Gulls Television Network. Jose Ortiz lead off for the Danbury Westerners as we go to the top of the fourth inning. The pitch to him is outside high, ball one. Tommy, you need to stop playing with my headset there. I keep hearing the static there. I think it's going out in the air when it's not. He's doing a great job on audio tonight. The pitch, low, ball one. Steve Andrade's our director tonight. Our graphics engineer is Ryan Betancourt. Here's the next delivery. That's missing up and away, ball three. 3-0 now, the count to Ortiz. We also have Chris Salisbury and Ryan Phoenix working on cameras. The pitch, outside ball four, he walked him. So, a leadoff walk on four pitches. Ortiz stands in at first. Here comes Malacone. Malacone doubled his last time up, stranded on base. John Malacone leading the Westerners with a 4.21 average. It's up a couple points now. He has 5 runs batted in, 2 home runs, tied for first in home runs. Throw to first, and Ortiz just does dive back in. So we do have a great crew in here for you tonight. 6 people, along with our production assistant, Mr. Raymond Ballard Sr., sitting next to me. Next pitch, instead another throw back to first. And Jeremy Hall is a very quick move to first. Not quite as deceptive as Mike Tossi's. Here's a pitch to the plate. That's inside, ball one. Looks like a changeup. It counts 1-0. Nobody out here in the fourth inning. First time a runner's been on tonight with no one out. Throw back to first, and did he get him? No, John Leeds says no, base umpire tonight. We've seen about 4 throws to first here to try and get Ortiz. The next pitch, that's on the inside corner of the pole trade, counts 1-1. Jose Ortiz has 1 stolen base this season in 2 attempts. 1-1 the count to Malacone. Instead, another throw back to first. Didn't get him. Well, Ortiz now has a very dirty uniform. He's been diving back every time. I don't think he's hopped back on the bag yet. And another throw to first. And he got him. He finally got him. Ortiz doesn't like it. He shouts at John Leeds. Ortiz retires the dugout, fires his helmet. He's disappointed. Ortiz had just, here's the instant replay of that. So, we didn't catch a tag, but he did get him by just barely on the pitch. It's way inside, back here alive. 2-1 the count to Malacone. So, very happy to have an instant replay back. Thank you for alerting me to that, Tommy. The 2-1 pitch, check swing. He went around and it's right down the middle anyway. The count's even at 2-2. So one man out and base is empty as Ortiz is retired. It's a whole different situation now as Hall pitching with more confidence. The 2-2 is swung on, fouled around the plate area. Oh, it's a fair ball and the pitcher catches it. A wild throw to first and he'll hold up there as it's backed up by the second baseman who had sprinted down there to back him up. Well, I thought that ball would go foul, but it was a chopper right around the plate area and rolled into fair territory in the infield. I don't think that, I don't know if we can get into replay on that one, but not exactly sure. if Mollicone would have been safe or not. I'll score it as an infield single, give him the benefit of the doubt. So, once again, Hall working with the runner at first, this time one out. Mahoney, who flew out his last time up to end the first inning, stands there from the left side of the plate. The pitch outside, on the outside corner now, late strike call from base umpire Pete Smith. The Westerners are 1-1 on the road, hoping to go 2-1 tonight here at Cardines. The pitch is hitting in the air, deep to center field. The center fielder takes a few steps back, looking up, and makes the catch. And they may have him at court at first. Here's the throw, and he steps at first. Well, that'll do it. As a base-running blunder, double play ends it for the Westerners here in the fourth. Mollicone had already rounded second. He thought that ball would be off the wall, but the wind knocked it down, and Bruner made the catch and just simply fired a lazy throw into the second baseman, which was cut off, and tossed the first. As Church took it, three alone for the out to retire the side. So a strange double play there to end the inning. And we've played 3.5, still no score as Hall and the Gulls get out of Miller Jam and continue on the Newport Gulls Television Network. Blake Church to lead things off here for the Newport Gulls in the last half of the fourth inning. Still no score, and Mike Tosse off of a fourth inning of work on the mound. His first pitch of the fourth inning to Church is swung on, grounded by the first baseman in the right field, a base hit. Church holds up there as it's snagged by Jeff Vincent. So Church has a leadoff single, and let's see, that's the second time tonight the Gulls have gotten their leadoff man on, and the second time tonight, Church has been that man. Church, reach on error by the shortstop to start off the second inning, starts off the fourth here with a leadoff single. Here comes Brown. Scott Brown, left-handed batter. The pitch is in there for a called strike, like a slider. Brown, right fielder for the Gulls, has a .261 batting average, has hit a double this season. Brown grounded into a 6-4-3 double play his last time up to retire Church. Church stands in at second, throw to him, not in time as he hops back on the bag. So it's Church at first, I should say. Brown at the plate. After Brown, we'll see Jarensinski and Schaefer, who are both 1-for-1 tonight. The pitch from Tosse is swung on and missed. Just got a piece of it, so he fouled it right off the catcher's equipment. And the count is 0-2 to Brown. Runner at first, outfield, not too deep. Infield, playing ground to pull. Tosse from the set, but instead of now throw to first. He's got that tricky delivery to first. You think he's throwing to the plate as he kicks and tosses over to first. Very deceptive. Not very fast, though, so he hasn't thrown anyone out yet. Plus, the Gulls, who don't steal often, don't take very large leads. The pitch is way outside. Something off speed. The count is 1-2. Brown in a little battle here now with Tosse. Church remains at first. Tosse's 1-2 pitch. Swinging a ground ball right by John Leeds. The base umpire flips the second out there on the first. Double play. Crowd didn't like it, but they did get him by a step. See if you can instant replay of that double play. I'm not sure. I usually have supposed to wait for the cue, but we'll see. 6-4-3 on the out. And for the second time tonight, Brown is grounded into a 6-4-3 double play. So with two outs, here comes Jarensinski. Jarensinski in the second inning doubled with two outs, followed by Schaefer's single. Burnham later grounded out in the inning. The pitch to Jarensinski is on the outside corner, the called strike. Oh, no double play, oh well. Well, we'll get the instant replay again later, I'm sure. Trying to use it more often. It's our director, Steve Andrade, a real veteran, a three-year veteran of the crew. Remembers how to do his job. The pitch is in right field, out four for a hit. Jaron Sinski, in a first and throw, gets away from the first baseman. Looked like Ortiz was a cutoff man, and got away from him, as the right fielder Vincent threw very low, and the pitcher tossed him in a diving catch. Up halfway up the first base line to save that ball from going into the plate area. Either way, I don't think Jaron Sinski could have advanced, but either way, he's on with a single. He's two for two tonight, definitely out of the slump now. Jaron Sinski came to the game batting just 133. He's moved to the DH position tonight. Perhaps that's helping a little bit. So Jaron Sinski now stands in that first. Another base runner for the Newport Hills. The pitch, outside ball one, a little bit low. Counts 1-0 to Warren Schaefer. Schaefer also in a slump as of late, singled his last time up. Schaefer is 1-for-1 tonight. Two outs here in the last half of the fourth inning. Tossi throws in the first. And Jaron Sinski's back standing. I thought we'll see too many steals off of Tossi tonight. He is a left-handed pitcher. And he stands so tall, you can probably see half of Newport from his stature on the mound. The pitch outside with a ball. Counts 2-0. So two men down. At the plate remains Schaefer. Tossi checks the runner, the 2-0 pitch. That's in there with a fastball at the knees on the outside corner. A called strike, counts 2-1. Tossi looks in for the sign, likes what he sees. Checks Jaron Sinski at first. The 2-1 pitch, swing and a foul to right field. Now hit over by the Munfield Pub onto West Marble Street, over by my car, and misses my car yet again. My car's only been hit twice. Both of those times happened in one game, which was the regular season finale in 2004. Hasn't been hit this season, not that I know of. It's not by ball hit from this park. Maybe the parking attendant might have done something, I don't know. The pitch, swing and a follow on the plate area. That hit, it's strike three. It's strike three, the pitch. Goes wide from first, and he's safe. And at second, as we let's see. Will that be a double? No. As we nearly lose our table there. Tommy, what are you doing? Tommy nearly kicks our table position out of here. We would have lost it all there. So what's happening now? Now they go back to the dugout. Was he out at first? Well, that's very confusing. So we nearly lose our table. The Gulls out here. Here comes Mike Coombs. He's going to argue the home plate umpire. It was a swing and a miss, it looked like. And he couldn't hold on to it. It's still, let's see if we can get a shot of Coombs arguing with the home plate umpire there. It's just a discussion. Well, the grounds crew's out cleaning off the bags. There they are. There's Mike Coombs, acting manager of the Newport Gulls, arguing, not really arguing, but discussing the situation with Pete Smith, the crew chief tonight. So there was a runner at first. He advanced to third, and the infield didn't know what to do. They stayed out there, and finally, I guess the third out was called. I couldn't see it from up here. Well, Coombs gives up. So that'll do it for the Gulls. They're retired. I don't know how to score it. I'll figure it out between innings. We've played four full here at Cardinals Field. Still no score on the Newport Gulls Television Network. First pitch of the top of the fifth is a called strike to the leadoff batter, Randy Ray. It'll be Ray, Ortiz, and Malacone here in the fifth inning. The pitch, low ball, one the count's 1-1. Jeremy Hall out for a fifth inning of work. Hall, 0-1 thus far in the season, still looking for his first win. Hall's next delivery is on the outside corner, a call strike, count's 1-2. looking in. Winds, kicks, and deals. Called third strike in the outside corner. Second strikeout of the night for Jeremy Hall. That's one out here in the fifth inning. Here comes Jose Ortiz. Ortiz flew out in the first, walked in the fourth. Ortiz is 1-for-1 tonight, or 0-for-1 tonight. The pitch from Hall, up and away, ball one. Oh, I guess we lost our backstop camera momentarily. They go to try and correct the situation. The pitch is fouled back and out of play. So we'll try and get our backstop cameras back as soon as we can. And we'll just go back down to one camera. Sorry about that, folks. We are a volunteer crew with amateur equipment here, doing the best we can. 1-1 the count, one out. Here in the top of the fifth inning, the batter is Brian Mailer. Where is he? That was Michael DeLuca, I should say. Michael DeLuca, who struck out looking. Mailer. Two and one the count now to Mailer as we correct the situation. The pitch. That's on the outside corner. The call strike counts even at 2-2. So it was DeLuca who struck out looking. And Mailer stands in. The next pitch. Outside the ball. And it counts 3-2. Full count now to Mailer. Hall with the payoff pitch. Ball four inside. He walked him. There's our camera, it's back and working again. As Mailer takes his bag at first, I want to take a moment to thank our audio technician and my brother, Tom Lima, who's been correcting problem after problem tonight with the broadcast. Some good work there. Good work, Tom. Say thanks for the people at
home. Thank you, Nick.
So I have two cameras now. Our runner at first. From the set, Hall. Pitch is outside, ball one, it's 1-0. Hall worrying about Mailer at first. Bellis at the plate, John Bellis. And a very big slump this season, the runner goes. The pitch is swung on, fouled around the plate area. Bellis ground out to the shortstop in the second inning. So it was DeLuca, actually, who struck out to start off this inning, and it was DeLuca who struck out to start off the second inning. Those are both the only two strikeouts tonight for Hall. Hall working at the count, 1-1 to Bellis. A runner at first, one out the pitch. Just missed on the outside corner below the belt, and the count's 2-1. Mailer takes a short lead at first. Hall with the 2-1 pitch. The runner goes again, that's fouled back again. Off the netting in front of our position here. Behind the backstop. 2-2 the count to Mailer, or rather to Bellis. It is Mailer at first. Bellis at the plate. After him, we'll see Vincent. Hall looks in for the sign. From the set, the 2-2 pitch. Ball three up and away, and the count is full. Outfield playing Bellis deep. Infield at double play deck. 3-2 the count, the runner may be going here. The payoff pitch, Mailer goes, and it's hit in the air to right field. Right fielder coming on, makes the catch for the inning second out. Mailer retreats back to the bag at first. There are now two men down in the inning. For Vincent. Jeff Vincent, right fielder, leading the Westerners in strikeouts with 7. Vincent flew out to left field last time. It was a great catch made by Zach Clement left. On that out, the pitch is way inside. Ball one. So Mailer, who walked at first. Two outs here in the fifth. 1-0 the count to Jeff Vincent. Ball's pitch. Outside, ball two, and the count's 2-0. Quite a crowd on hand tonight. Maybe a sellout. Get the attendance report later. The 2-0 pitch. Outside again, 3-0. Well, we don't have a pitch count on Hall, but he has been going deep into several of the counts. He's only struck out two batters. Seen a lot of flyouts, a couple ground outs with 3-2 pitches. The pitch is, that's in there for a called strike, give strike call from Pete Smith. Hit his count now, 3-1. Runner at first. Two outs. Hall checks the runner at first, and he jumps back on the bag. Toes the rubber, looks in, quickly now to the set. The 3-1 pitch, a run and go. Swing and a miss, strike two, is the throw to second. It is in time, they got him, and the inning is over. Sean McGill with an on-target throw to second baseman Jeff Miller. We'll see an instant replay on that. Let's see it as we rewind the tape. Here it is. It was standing in Vincent, and the play was in time and got him. See if they can see that one more time, perhaps in slow motion. No, we can't. Oh, well. But we'll continue working on that, folks, and the Newport Gulls. We'll be up to bat in the last half of the fifth inning as we continue next on the Newport Gulls Television Network. Back in now at Cardines Field, we do have the instant replay of that great throw-em-out play to end the inning. Here it is. As the runner went, throw to second was in time, and they did get him. So the Sean McGill, in his second season with Newport, really just having a stellar season thus far. His average isn't great. He's batting .243, and it'll likely go up as the season progresses. However, he does have a home run. He is leading the team 3 doubles. McGill has made some great defensive plays thus far. Really showing his worth for the Gulls. We're here in the last half of the fifth inning. Leading off for the Newport Gulls will be Nick Burnham. Burnham, center fielder for Newport, batting .250, ground out in the second his last time up. And out for another inning of work is Michael Tosse. Tosse has pitched 4 scoreless innings thus far. Still don't see any action up in the bullpen yet. We'll get word on that momentarily. Tosse allowed a double to Clem in the first, and 2 hits in the second, and another hit in the fourth. He's going to have 4 hits tonight. His only strikeout came in the fourth inning to Schaefer. Schaefer struck out looking, or rather swinging. That was a very strange play there in the last half and fourth. Well, a couple more warm-up pitches for Tosse, and that will probably do it. And here comes Nick Burnham, number 3. Babe Ruth's number 3. We are here in New England. They're ready to go now as the catcher, Malacone, takes his position behind the plate. On deck for the Newport Gulls is the leadoff batter, Jeff Miller. Miller will be followed by Infante and Clem. Burnham stands in. Tosse's pitch is swung on, hit in the air to right field deep. The right fielder looks at it, makes the catch. And did he drop it? He did drop it. He dropped the ball out there in right field. Oh, no, he didn't. So he made the catch, he held on long enough, and then dropped it. So it is Burnham retired. I do have a pull in my way here, folks. He made the catch, held on to it long enough, and as he went to make the throw, dropped it. So Burden retired on one pitch. He cycled around to the top of the order, and Jeff Miller. Miller grounded out. Fire three in the first, 6-3 in the third. Tossi with the pitch. He squares for a bunt, pulls it back away. The pitch is outside, ball one, it's 1-0. Well, no action in the Ghost bullpen, so we'll probably see Jeremy Hall again in the sixth. Here in the last half of the fifth inning. Once again, the pitch from Tossi. On the outside, calling the call, strike, the count is 1-1. One man out. Base is empty. Crowd trying to rally the goals. Get some more hits here. A pitch, check swing, he went around, and it's in there anyway for a call. Strike counts 1-2. What a crowd here tonight at Cardines. Friday night baseball at its best, folks. Tossi in a pitcher's duel with Hall. The 1-2 pitch in the dirt, blocked by the catcher, Mollicone. And the count's even at 2-2. My mozzarella sticks will be arriving shortly. Tossi once again with the 2-2 pitch. Low ball three. The count is full. One out here in the home half of the fifth. Still no score in this ball game. Tossi with the 2-2 pitch. Swinging a weak hit, ground ball roll up the first baseline. This may be tough play to make. They can't get the tag on him, and he's on at first. Miller, with his first hit in a Gulls uniform, stands in at first base. Miller is now 1-for-3 tonight. So the Gulls get their leadoff man on for Michael Affronti. Here's an instant replay as they look like. I'll try to figure out who that is who had the ball. It was number 11, Jose Ortiz, the first baseman. As Miller, with the dirty uniform, had a dive into the back at first. That's a rare play. So Ortiz really had to dive in there and could not make the tag. And now there's a small argument. And the argument is lost by the head coach and manager, Rusty Gosselin. So Miller at first for Affronti. Hometown, well not, he doesn't live in the area, but he is a hero here in Newport. And great season last year, and even better season thus far this year. Franny stands in the pitch, swinging on ground ball roller right to the third base, and fires the second. Out there, it's wide, but he is out. He did tag the bag for the force. So great play by the second baseman, Matt Thiel, who held on to the ball, and Franny to be on the fielder's choice at first. So Miller, who reached in a wild play, now retired, and Franny stands in. That call could have been two, but the throw was wide, and you can't assume a double play, so no error there. Franny stands in with a fearless choice. Zach Clem comes up to bat. Clem is 2-for-2 tonight on his first night in a Ghost uniform. Clem, double in the first, was later retired on a double play, or rather, was left stranded at second base. So double in the first, and the third inning single, and was stranded again. McGill unable to deliver. And each time he did reach base, there were two outs. And once again, here in the fifth, there were two outs. The throw back to first, Affronti dives back in. So, two men down, and once again, Zach Clem at the plate. Affronti at first. Mike Tossi. It's now time's call. Well, he. What's happening here? Let's see who is that coming out to the bag, number 14. That's Kevin Long, the pitching coach. I have to talk with Tossi. Tossi, it's okay. And they're just going over strategy. No, he's showing his wrists. to the hand. But now it looks like a pitching coach is just giving out instructions. So seems to be all right. As here comes the plate umpire, Pete Smith, to break things up. It's Malacone, pitching coach, speaking with Tossie. All right, they break it up. Last word from the coach, Kevin Long, who heads back to the dugout. Malacone takes his position behind the plate. Tossie worries about a fronty at second, or a fronty at first. Two outs. Looks in for the sign. Now they're ready. Clem stands in. The pitch, instead of throw to first, and a fronty hops back on the bag. Oh, it's starting to get dark here at Cardinals Field, and just as I say that, the lights come on. Another throw to first, a fronty back standing. Lights warming up as the sun sets behind, below the clouds in the distance. A little bit ominous looking, but hopefully showers will stay away tonight. There are scattered showers in the area. The pitch outside with the ball counts 1-0. I do see some weak thunder clouds in the distance. Cumulus clouds rising into the sky. However, clear skies directly above the city of Newport. The 1-0 is up and away. Ball two, it's 2-0. Winds died down a little bit, still blowing pretty steadily, maybe about 5 to 12 miles per hour. Haven't had many gusts in a while, if we did later on earlier on in the afternoon. Franny still at first, 2-0 the count to Clem. Tossie looks in, checks Afrani. Another throwback to him. Afrani dived in and he's safe. He's safe. Afrani throws his hands in the air. He's getting tired of diving back into the bag. He's not going to be stealing on a left-handed pitcher. Maybe he will here just to spite him. We'll see. Afrani takes a long lead. Now he goes. Afrani dives in, no throw. Afrani in at second. Afrani spikes Mike Tossie here. He wasn't too happy about all the throws to first, and he took off there. So the Gulls have a runner in scoring position now for Clem with two outs. Still waiting for the first strike of the at-bat to Clem. Tossie checks up fronting at second, no one covering the 2-0 pitch. Pitch out. No one covering though. So it counts 3-0. Will they walk Clem here? Will they walk him to face McGill? McGill's a cleanup hitter. And they will. So it's gonna be a pitch out. So intentional walk issued to Clem here. And we'll see Sean McGill. Well, see if we can get a shot of the bullpen. With runners at first and second now. Still no score here in the home half of the fifth. Sean McGill, 0-2 tonight. Grounded out in the first, flew out the center in the third. McGill, cleanup hitter for Newport. Hit a three-run homer on his first at-bat back at Cardinals Field for his second season here as a Gull. Like to hit one here. Westerners and the Gulls are tied for first place in the Southern Division. McGill awaits the pitch. It's outside, ball one with a fastball. It counts 1-0. Afrani at second, Clem at first. Clem's reached base all three times tonight. Afrani, a reach on a fielder's choice. Clem was intentionally walked. Two outs. McGill at the plate. Afrani hops around. And now heads back to second as Matt Thiel came in to cover. Afrani is a base-stealing threat. He already did steal second. The pitch. Low and inside, ball two, and it's 2-0. So even with two outs, Tossie is in real jam here versus McGill, who does have some power. McGill, a catcher for Boston College. Once again, second year as a goal. Runners at first and second. Tossie with the 2-0 pitch. On the outside corner with a called strike. It's 2-1. Outfield, very deep. Infield takes a few steps back on the edge of the grass. Tossie looks in. Runners up first and second, and Affronti hops back on. Once again, he looks in. McGill levels the bat from the set. The 2-1 pitch. Swinging a weak hit ground ball. Third baseman has it. He'll fire to first. In, did they get him in time as McGill trips over his glove? They got McGill in the goal of strand, two runners on. Well, almost another wild play there as a third baseman, John Bellis, picked up the ground ball from McGill. Tried to tag up front, he failed there, then had a second to throw out McGill at first for the out there, he ties the side. The goals do not score, they strand two. After a five full of Cardines Field, still no score in the Newport Gulls Television Network. Back here at Cardines Field, first pitch to Jeff Vincent. Missing ball one, it's 1-0. Vincent, who is at bat in the count 3-2 on him his last time up when Mailer was caught stealing. Vincent ahead now 2-0. The next pitch from Hall is out on the outside corner now. The call strike, it's 2-1. Hall has not given up a run yet in five innings of work. The pitches foul off the screen, and the count's even at 2-2. Crowd looking for a strikeout. Several thousand of them, maybe three. We'll find out later. Hall looking in. A 2-2 pitch. Ball. Three low, just missed. We'll do it again. Vincent is 0-1 tonight. His last at bat did not count. Hall's payoff pitch, swing and a high fly ball to right field deep. Right fielder looking up at the wall, leaps, can't make the catch. Vincent rounding first, rounding second, he'll be sending the third. Here's the throw, and it is cut off, not in time, gets away. Vincent, and at third, the leadoff triple. Well, the tables have turned here now. Vincent stands in at third. That was hit about 10 feet up the wall and right. Here's an instant replay of that, as the right fielder was unable to make the catch, and Vincent came all the way around, and the throw did get away. Back here live is Matt Teal. Teal batting here with a runner at third. No score. The pitch. Swing, another high hit. Hard hit ball to right field. This may score a run. And it's not too deep as Vincent retreats back to third. Teal hit that ball to right field, but not deep enough. He got under it too much. And Brown made the catch. So, still a runner at third, now with one out. Still a jam here for Jeremy Hall. Very dangerous situation. Sean McGill comes out to talk with Hall. Here comes Affronti in to discuss a few things. The entire infield comes in now, except for the third baseman. Now he comes in now too. Well, they'll discuss what to do here. Big conference out on the mound. Vincent at third. In the top of the order up, Randy Ray. Ray's 0-2 tonight, grounding out both times up in the first and third. After him, we'll see Ortiz, who flew out in the first, walked in the fourth. Then Malacone, who doubled in the first and had an infield single in the fourth. One man out. Hopefully it won't get that far. A runner at third for Randy Ray. Ray is batting 208 with two home runs. Paul in trouble. Runner at third. A lot pitch. Swing and a foul right off the screen. That knocked out camera position awry. And I'll correct that. That hit right off of our camera position, folks. Yeah, it doesn't look too good. We'll work on that one. ball with the 0-1 pitch to Randy Ray. Here it is, up and away, ball one, trying to get Vincent at third, but he was didn't come down the line enough. Infield comes in. The outfield comes in. Any ball hit deep to the outfield will get that run home. No score, the goal's trying to keep it that way. Ball with the 1-1 pitch. That's a high fly ball to center field deep. Way back it goes, it is gone, a home run. Just like that, it's 2-0. As Randy Ray hits his third homer of the season and puts the Westerners on top, 2-0. There goes the shutout for Hall. That's the first home run he's given up this year. And the bases are empty now with one out. 2-0 our score. As our camera position is just about fixed now. The pitch is fouled back and out of play. Some minor corrections to make. There they are. Once again, it's my brother, audio technician Tom Lemer, saving the day to save our camera. Well, two-run homer by Ray with one out here in the sixth. It's 2-0, the pitch. Outside ball one. These Westerners really have some power. They've hit quite a few home runs on Tuesday night at Denver. Here's the next pitch. That's hit, foul back and out of play. The Westerners had three solo home runs all in the same inning, as well as a two-run homer in the inning before that. It was the third and fourth innings to take the lead 5-0. They went on to win the game 7-5 after the goals came back to tie at 5 apiece. Their second loss of the season. The goal is trying to avoid a fourth loss here tonight. They did lose Wednesday night versus Keene. They had last night off, their first night off in 9 days. Newport playing another long stretch here. They come to their feet, the 2-2 pitch is lining in the right field, a base hit. Ortiz on at first. Ortiz is now 1-for-2 tonight. So back-to-back hits given up by Hall. 3 hits so far in the inning. And that we will see action up in the Gulls bullpen. They send a pitcher out there. Let's see who that is. It looks like Griffin Bailey. Bailey out there, middle reliever for the Gulls. Bailey trots out to the bullpen. Hall still has to worry about a runner at first. One out, 2 runs home in the inning. Trying to keep the score close so Newport can come back in the latter innings. Time's running out, the pitch. It's in there for a called strike. Newport on Wednesday night led for the majority of the game until giving up 7 runs in the ninth to lose it. Now I throw back to first and Ortiz back standing. Or rather, I should say died back in. Hall comes to the set. To the belt, to the plate. Outside ball one, it's 1-1. Well, he needs to get that second out here to move this inning along, or else it may be a big inning for the Westerners. Hall looks in. Looks like he's annoying the runner at first. The pitch, the runner goes, that's the call to the strike. There's a throw to second. In time they got him, a strike him out, throw him out, double play. Rather, I apologize, folks. That was strike two. So it counts 1-2, but they did retire Ortiz, who's caught stealing. Here's the instant replay on that. And they did get him just by a fraction of a second. He wasn't too happy. So 1-2 the count. They come to the feet. Cardi's field, the pitch is inside. Almost hit him ball two. The count's at 2-2. Well, Hall's giving up a 2-run homer to Randy Ray with one out in this inning. There are 2 men out now that Ortiz has been caught stealing. Malcolm awaits the 2-2 pitch from Hall. Here it is. Swing and a miss, he struck him out. Paul gets a standing ovation from some of the crowd here at Cardines, who are very happy with his performance thus far. He has given up two runs on that shot by Rennie Ray, but other than that, he's pitched outstanding baseball tonight. That may do it for him tonight as Griffin Bailey is warming up in the bullpen. Well, the Westerners get two, and after 5.5 at Cardines Field, it's 2-0 Danbury here on the Newport Gulls Television Network. Back here now at Cardines Field, Blake Church, who has his own theme music, stands in at the plate. Church out of East Tennessee State. Here's the pitch to him. It's outside, ball one. Catcher Malenko in trouble getting a grip on that one. Well, Tosse now has a two-run lead to work with, 2-0. Here in the last half of the sixth inning, the goalie's trying to strike back. Pitch is in the air for a called strike, and it's 1-1. Blake Church led off the second. Reached on error by the shortstop, led off the fourth, and singled to right, hoping to lead off here with a hit, and that's hit in the air to right field, but foul. And out of play, he's in a hole now, 1-2. Blake Church hoping to get something going for the goals now. They need base runners. 2-0 our score. Tosse still pitching scoreless baseball as the lights are on here at Cardines Field. The pitch, swing and a high fly ball to right field deep. The right fielder looking up and makes the catch about 15 feet shy of the wall near the track. So Church is retired. Church heads back to the dugout. Here comes Scott Brown. The pitch to Brown. It's in there for a called strike. Tosse with the next delivery. Outside the ball, it counts even out, 1-1. One out here in the sixth inning. Tosse's 1-1 delivery is outside, ball two. It's 2-1 to Scott Brown. Brown now into 6-4-3 double plays in the second and fourth innings. Tosse's 2-1 pitch, swing and a miss, strike two, and the count's even at 2-2. Tosse looks in for the sign. Base is empty, one out. Wines kicks and deals. A 2-2 pitch. Check swing, he didn't go around, and the pitch is outside with an off-speed pitch, and the count's full. And Brown continues to stand in. A 3-2 pitch. Ball four, he walked him. 1-hour walk issued here. That'll bring the tying run to the plate in the form of Jarensinski. Ryan Jarensinski, double in the second, single in the fourth. As we contend with a contingent of children here up in the broadcast booth, which is more of the stands, I should say, behind the plate area. Curiously perched up here, and now they all retreat. The children, that is. Runner at first. Jarensinski get the play. Jarensinski is 0-2 tonight. The pitch to him is outside, and the dirt ball one. Tosse with the runner at first. The pitch, that's in the air, deep to center field. He got under it, and it is gone, a home run. That was hit way back to center, over the 30-foot mark, and the Newport Gulls have tied the score 2-2. Jarensinski is 3-for-3 tonight. That's his first home run of the season, and he's greeted by his teammates at the plate. It is a new ball game, folks. Ryan Jarensinski with a two-run homer to right center field, over the 30-foot wall, off the light tower. And the Gulls have tied it up. It's 2-2. Right back in this ball game now. So all the scoring tonight being accomplished on two-run homers. We're here in the last half of the sixth. Base is empty with one out, and our camera's messed up again. I'll send my brother off to fix that. Our audio technician, Tom Lima. Well, that's the first scoring given up by Tossie's pitches. Missing the ball to Owen Schaefer. Tossie working quickly. A low 1-0 pitch. On the inside corner of the court, strike counts even at 1-1. The crowd right back into this game now. The score tied at 2 apiece. Our camera position is corrected. The pitch, swinging a ground ball chopper. Second baseman has to come on hard and throws the first for the out. Schaefer retired 4-3. He's now 1-for-3 tonight. Here comes Nick Burnham. Burnham, 0-for-2 tonight. Ground out in the second. Flew out to right field in the fifth. That was the first out in the fifth. We have two outs now here in the sixth. And Burnham will be batting. Two runs already home in the inning for Newport. Tossie. His shutout is over. The pitch. Missing with a ball. So the sixth inning has proved to be the best inning for each team thus far. Each team the two-run homer. And my Mozzarella sticks have arrived. Well, it's been a great inning. The pitch. That's on the inside corner of the court. Strike counts 1-1. So the goal is here, a two-run homer. Ray Ballard Sr. returns with a full bottle of water for Nick Lima, myself, and Mozzarella sticks as well. The pitch is ground ball chopper. Third baseman has done a hop, flies long way to first in time. Oh, gets away for the first baseman. Burnham running first. He'll be sent in the second. He's tagged out at second base. Well, he was sent around, and that'll do it for the goals. However, they do have a two-run home run by Brian Chansinski, who's 3-for-3 thus far tonight. And the Gulls have tied the score 2-2 here on the Newport Gulls Television Network. Back here now at Cardines Field. First pitch is called strike to Mahoney. Hall. Oh, and it's not Hall anymore. It's now a lefty up on the mound. Here's the pitch from him. That's a ground ball chopper. The short's up front. He has it. Fires the first in time for the inning's first out. The new pitcher for the Newport Gulls is, in fact, number 11, Josh Laercy. Laercy, 6.75 ERA. He's 1-0 in six appearances. He has many starts. He's solely a relief pitcher. There's a good shot of him right now. Laercy, second pitcher of the night for the Newport Gulls. He's pitched 12 innings, given up 19 hits, nine runs, all American. He's walked four, struck out 13. Lacey has given up six doubles, a triple, and a home run. He's ahead now, 0-2 on DeLuca. DeLuca struck out looking in the second, struck out looking in the fifth. Lacey's next delivery is swung on, chopped, foul up the third base line. So Lacey. Places Jeremy Hall, who gave up just a two-run shot to Randy Ray. The pitch, swing and a miss, strike three, struck him out. First strikeout of the night for Lacey in relief of Hall. And there are two men out in the inning. So Lacey getting the job done thus far. As we are here in the top of the seventh, 2-2 score. Well, Matt Mailer takes first pitch outside ball one. Lacey's working very quickly here. Once again, Lacey's pitch. That's on the outside corner of the court. Strike, the count's even out 1-1. Mailer flew out in the second. Walked and was later caught stealing in the fifth. The pitch is outside, on the outside corner now, late strike ball. And it counts 1-2. So two outs, crowd looking for a strikeout. Lacy with the 1-2 pitch. Just missed outside, the count's even at 2-2. My mozzarella sticks have arrived, folks. That's why I didn't notice the pitching change. Chomping on them between innings. I love them, folks. The 2-2 pitch. Swinging a weak hit ground ball. Foul up the first base line. And a little race there by a couple of Westerners to retrieve that foul. As they play an underhand game of catch with it on the way back to the dugout. Once again, the 2-2 is swung on and missed strike three. Back-to-back strikeouts for Josh Lissy. It's a 1-2-3 inning. And a new t-shirt's thrown right by us here in the broadcast booth precariously. That was dangerous. Well, anyway, of course, every strikeout by Ghost pitching, a new fan earns a t-shirt here at Cardines. And that one was thrown right over our head. Nearly knocked out our broadcast table. Well, that's a 1-2-3 inning for Lacy in his first inning of relief. We played 6.5 here at Cardings Field. Still tied at 2-2 here on the New Broad Gulls Television Network. Seventh inning stretch time. Let's pause for a moment for Take Me Out to the Ball Game. Here now at Cardines Field, it is number 13, the leadoff batter, Jeff Miller. In his first game in the Ghost uniform, he takes the first pitch outside on the outside corner called strike. Miller grounding out 5-3 in the first, grounding out 6-3 in the third, and single in the fifth. Next pitch of Miller is in there for a called strike. Out for a seventh inning of work is the hard throwing Mike Tossie. Legs what he sees now, the 1-2 pitch. Check swing, he went around, it's a called strike. So Miller goes down. And we will now see Michael Affronti. Affronti grounded out to the shortstop in the first. Reached on error by the second baseman in the third. Reached on a fielder's choice in the fifth. Affronti bats now from the right side of the plate. As our camera's fixed again, the pitch is missing outside, ball one. It's 1-0. We're here in the last half of the seventh, still tied at 2-2. Tossie's next pitch. Low in the dirt, ball two, and it's 2-0. Newport Gulls and the Danbury Rustlers were tied at 2-2 after the 10th inning got finished in the extra inning game last Saturday night. Pitch. Missing the ball, the count's 3-0 to Affronti. That game was halted at 11 o'clock due to a league rule. The Gulls had to get back home. And it was picked up on Tuesday. And the Westerners did end up winning the game. And the pitcher is in there for a call, a strike right down the middle for fastball. Hitters count now 3-1 on Affronti. The Westerners did win that game after Affronti hit a home run in the 11th inning to take the lead 3-2. They got a run back, and there's a 3-1 pitch. Swing and a weak hit ground ball. Third baseman has it on a hop. He boots the ball, and he has no play. Affronti's on. All right, that was the third baseman's ball. He should have made that play. So Affronti reaches tonight for the second time on an error. Anyway, in that extra innings game in the 11th, Affronti hit a solo home run. The Gulls took the lead 3-2. And in the bottom of the inning, at Danbury, the Westerners came back, lowered the bases, scored a run, tied at 3-3. Still the bases loaded with two outs, were out of position players, and the pitcher, who had to bat since they had no position players left to fill in for DH, came up to bat, suicide squeeze, and they won the ball game on a walk-off suicide squeeze. That was the Gulls' first loss. They did lose the second game that night, 7-5. Conference out on the mound between Rusty Gosselin and the pitcher and the catcher. And we will have a pitching change here as a new pitcher comes in for the bullpen. We'll see who that is shortly. We have a pitching change coming to you from Cardines Field with the score tied at 2 apiece, a runner at first and one out as we continue here on the Newport Gulls Television Network. Back here now at Cardines Field, the new pitcher for the Danbury Westerners is Carlo Wirtz. Wirtz has a 1.690 earned run average. He's 1-0 in 3 appearances. He's made 1 start. Wirtz has 1 save. He's pitched 5.1 innings, given up 2 hits, 1 run. That was an earned run. He walked 3, struck out 3, gave up 1 home run. Wirtz taking a few more practice pitches out on the mound now. It is Michael Afrani standing in at first. He's the go-ahead run for Newport with 1 out here in the 7th. Wirtz's predecessor, Mike Tosse, left-handed pitcher. Wirtz is right-handed. Tosse gave up just 2 runs on a 2-run shot by Brian Jerenczynski back in the 6th inning. Other than that, Tosse pitch pretty much scoreless baseball and leaves here with no decision. Tied at 2 apiece here in the home half of the 7th. 1 out. Franny at first and Clem comes to the plate. Clem in his first night here at Cardines Field and goes uniform. Zach Clem. Double in the 1st. Single in the 3rd. Intentionally walked in the 5th. Clem batting now once again. For the 3rd time batting tonight with Franti at first base. Michael Franti is a base stealing threat. Takes his lead at first. The first pitch floats in there. Looks like a knuckleball from the new pitcher, Carl Wirtz, or Wirtz. So Wirtz may be a knuckleball out there on the mound. It's a very slow pitch, just floated in there. Add some motion on it. Let's see how his next delivery works. That's popped up, playable on the infield, now fading to the outfield, left fielder. Makes the catch, and Franti heads back first. The wind blew it out there to left field, and Brian Mailer made the put out. So that, just like that, to a 2 out in the inning, the goal is not threatening as much now. For Sean McGill, McGill's over 3 tonight, grounded out in the 1st, flew out in the 3rd, grounded out in the 5th. Each time he grounded out and flew out to end the inning. Batting here with 2 outs. McGill stands in, the pitch. Swing and a shot off the top of the broadcasting booth behind the home plate area. The count's 0-1 to McGill. Franti remains at first with 2 outs. Carl Wirtz. Clearly not a power pitcher. See a real fastball from him. The pitch, way inside. And the count to McGill is 1-1. So 2 men down here in the home half of the 7th. Score tied at 2 apiece, up running at first. Wirtz, second pitcher of the night for the Westerners. The pitch, swing and a miss. Strike 2, the count's 1-2 to McGill. McGill. Trying to avoid going 0-for-4 tonight. His average is dropping a little bit as we head towards the midpoint of the season, coming up in about a week and a half. Throw to first, and Franti dives back in. Wirtz. Kyle Wirtz looks in from the set, the pitch. Swing and a high fly ball to left field deep. Left fielder looking up and will make the catch. For the out there, he ties his side. A goal, Shannon Franti at first. They've left plenty tonight, and the score remains tied at 2 apiece as we continue on the Newport Gulls Television Network. And back back here once again at Cardine's Field. 2-2 is going to the top of the eighth inning. John Bellis to lead it off. He's 0-2 tonight. The first pitch is swung on and missed. Strike one from Lacy. Josh Lacy, we've seen a lot of him thus far this season in a relief role. Lacy looks in for the sign. Likes what he sees. Winds, kicks, and deals. Swung on and missed. Strike two. The count's 0-2. Well, I've had my mozzarella sticks now. I've had most of my chicken cheddar bacon sandwich in the concession stand. I'm going to get fat eating this food, folks, but well, it was my good dinner. 0-2 pitch is swung on, hit foul, lined up the third base line. Twilight is upon us here at Cardine's Field. The lights are on fully, illuminating the field. The sun sets behind the ominous looking clouds out towards the west. The 0-2-1-2 delivery is fouled up the first base line. It was the 0-2 delivery. And Bellis does stay alive. He grounded out to the shortstop in the second and flew out back in the fifth. All the scoring in the nice game is done in the sixth. That pitch is lined to the ground to the shortstop. Friday fires the first. Good play. As he double flush and waited for Church to get to the bag. And Bellis is retired here in the eighth for the inning's first out. Here comes Vincent, Jeff Vincent, right fielder for the Westerners. Has 7 strikeouts on the season. Vincent flew out to the left field of Clem in the third. Clem made a great diving catch to retire Vincent. Vincent then tripled in the sixth inning, later scored on the 2-run homer by Ray. Again, all of the scoring was done in the sixth inning. 2-run homers by both teams at the top and bottom of the inning. We're here in the eighth. First pitcher swung on a miss to Vincent. Does have some power. That triple was hit deep to right field, about the 380-foot marker, about 15 feet up the wall. The pitch, swinging, that's another high fly ball to right field, not as deep, and it's caught just shy of foul territory near the giant warehouse out there by the right fielder Brown for the inning second out. So, two up, two down. Lacy looking for another 1-2-3 inning of relief. He struck out DeLuca and Mailer to end the seventh after Mahoney grounded out in the inning. Well, here in the eighth, Bellis has grounded out. Vincent has flew out, and Lacy just has to deal with Teal. The pitch to Teal is bunted foul into the visiting Westerners dugout. Teal is 0-2 tonight, grounded out to the shortstop in the third and flew out in the sixth. Teal's bottom of the order for the Westerners. It's at the top of the order, maybe up at the ninth if Teal's retired here. The 0-1 pitch in the dirt. Not a good pitch by Lacy there. Lacy isn't really wild. One may get away from him every now and then. McGill didn't like it though, so he'll have a quick chat with his pitcher. Lacy McGill out there on the mound. Base is empty, 2 outs here in the eighth. We're still tied at 2 apiece. It's been a pitcher's duel all along. Aside from a 2-run homer given up by each starting pitcher in the sixth inning. Other than that, the line's a fairly evening. A few hits given up by each pitcher. A walk or two. A few strikeouts, not too many, by the starters at least. Lacy with the 1-1 delivery. On the inside corner, great pitch from Lacy, and the count's 1-2. Teal was looking for something off speed there. He didn't get it. The 1-2 pitch. Just missing the outside. Perhaps a little low, and the count's even at 2-2. In the ninth for the goals, we'll see Church, Brown, and Jaron Sinski. Rather than the last of the eighth, the pitcher swung on and fouled around the plate area. Last of the eighth, we'll see those three batters, not the ninth. We're still here at the top of the eighth, and once again, we'll see a 2-2 pitch to Teal. Josh Lacy really settling in now to his middle relief role for the Newport Gulls as the wind picks up a little bit here at Cardine's Field. Temperature's steadily dropping all night, a degree or two every hour. Lacy's pitch is grounded right to the second baseman, has it, fires the first. In time, he got him, a great play at first. And a great play, I should say, by the second baseman, Miller, who fired the first in time. For the other, he ties the side. So, for the second inning in a row, the Westers go down 1-2-3. We've played 7.5 here at Cardinals Field, still tied 2 apiece here at the Newport Gulls Television Network. Back here now at Cardinals Field, we do have an instant replay of the out that retired the side in the top of the inning. Here it is. There's a ground ball right up the middle. And we just missed a great turnaround play by the second baseman for the Newport Gulls. Jeff Miller. So Miller had an outstanding play to send this game into the last half of the eighth. Here's the pitch. Outside, and catcher John Milikone had to go to his knees to keep that ball from going to the backstop. It wouldn't have mattered. Base is empty. 1-0 the count. Church pitch floats in there for a called strike. Counts even at 1-1. Blake Church, return error by the shortstop in the second to start off the second. Single to right field to start off the fifth and led off the sixth by flying out. The pitch. Swing, and there's a line drive. Base hit in the left field. Church is at first. He'll be waiting around a second. He will hold up there now as the throw comes into the cutoff man, the shortstop. Blake Church leads off another inning by reaching base. He's now 2-for-3 tonight. Church stands in that second with the double. He represents the go-ahead run for the Newport Gulls. Now get the crowd going here at Cardinals Field. We do have an official attendance report. 2,632. That's about 450. Well, maybe about 600 shy of a shutout, of a sellout. Still early in the season. Friday night baseball, 26-32, the pitch. Tempted butt up the first base line. Here's the throw to first. In time, they got him. Church advances to third. That'll put the go-ahead run 90 feet from the plate as Scott Brown sacrifices with a bunt up the third base line. He put down a good one. Sacrifice bunt for Brown. And here comes Jaron Sinski. Brian Jaron Sinski is 3-for-3 tonight. Doubled in the second. Single in the fourth. Hit a 2-run home run to right field deep. Right center field. Over the 30-foot high fence and near the light tower. In the sixth inning. That gave us our score. He tied the ball game with that home run at 2 apiece. Jaron Sinski in a designated hitter role. In a slump as of late. He's been doing great tonight. He's 3-for-3. Blake Church at third. Reef Coffin's out on the mound. 2,632 fans. 2,632. Biggest crowd of the season. More than the 2,000 we saw on Military Appreciation Night last Wednesday. A crowd really into this game now. All runner at third. Jaron Sinski. At the plate, the pitcher, Kyle Wirtz with the pitch. It's missing outside, ball one, it's 1-0. Kyle Wirtz has to worry about Church at third. Church has some speed. Wirtz from the set, the 1-0. Swing and a drive to left center field. The center fielder looking up, makes a catch. Here's Church, he's tagging. The throw is into the plate, it is not in time, and the Gulls take the lead 3-2. And they come to defeat a Cardinals Field of 2, and Jaron Sinski with a sacrifice fly as a count for all 3 runs. The Newport Gulls have had tonight. Newport leads it 3-2. We'll see an instant replay on that. We'll have to see an instant replay on that one. As Jaron Sinski flies out to the left fielder, The St. Churchill base is empty now with two outs, and the Newport has their first lead of the ball game, 3-2. Here's the replay that was caught by the left fielder, and then the throw to the plate as Blake was sent down the line. Just not in time, and Blake scored. Back here live once again. So Jaron Siski has three runs batted in on the night. The pitch, swinging a foul to the backstop. The count's 0-1 to Warren Schaefer. Schaefer, single in the second, struck out, swinging in the fourth. Ground out 4-3 and 6. Newport's taking the lead here, 3-2 in the eighth. The crowd with their chant, "I believe the Gulls will win," from the championship game of last year. The pitch, missing, well rather in there for close strike, it's 0-2 to Schaefer. That chant was used throughout the playoffs by the crowd, who will the Gulls base hits. Well, a base hit wasn't accomplished by Jaron Siski, but that sacrifice fly was good enough as the Gulls now lead it 3-2. The pitch, swinging a foul off the netting next to the screen, and he stayed alive. So Kyle Ritz is now going to be, he's the pitcher of record now, and he stands to get the loss. Keep going, Ritz. Same as Wirtz. He's not a classy hotel in Britain. He winds, kicks, and deals. Outside with the ball. The count's 1-2. Two outs, 3-2 here in the eighth. Newport Gulls leading it. Warren Schaefer, 1-for-3 tonight, stands in at the plate. Waits the pitch from Wirtz. From the stretch, the 1-2. Missing just outside. The count's even at 2-2. So that means Josh Lacy's in the win now. See if he can keep it in the ninth. A 2-2 pitch. Swinging a little looper in the left field. Now, not very hard hit at all. Actually, he's caught by the shortstop. For the other, he ties his side, but not before. Jaron Siski does it again tonight, breaking out of his slump with a sacrifice flyer and run batted in to send Church home from third. The goal is getting it done here in the eighth. We go to the ninth inning. Last chance for the Western is next as we continue on the second season of the Newport Gulls Television Network. Back here now, Cardinals Field, top of the order, due up here in the ninth. Randy Wright takes the first pitch outside, ball one. Wright came into this game batting 208 with two home runs. He now has three. And there's action now on both bullpens. Lasty with the pitch. Missing low in the dirt. Ball two, it's 2-0. Randy Wright grounded out in the first and third innings. Hit the two-run home run in the sixth to give the Westerners a 2-0 lead. The Gulls, another two runner in the sixth, bottom of the sixth. That pitch is swung on and missed. Strike one, the count is 2-1. Chase the fastball. That was outside and way too fast for him. Lassie with the 2-1 delivery. Swinging a hot hit ground ball. Nice snap by the third baseman. Fires the first, high and wide, and it gets away. Here he comes, running first. He's going to second. Here's a throw to second. In time, they got him out of second base. Well, Randy Ray tried to send a single into a double after third baseman Schaefer made a great one-handed catch on a hot hit ground ball right to him. Here's the instant replay on that. It was right to Schaefer. He made a great snag, fired to the first, high and wide. He got away, and they made a great effort to cover that ball in time and throw him out at second. That's one man down in the inning. And there are only two outs left here for the Danbury Westerners. Back here live once again. Pinch hitter for Danbury. Flies out the right field. That's the inning, second out. That was a pinch hitter for the Westerners, Paul Cellini. Paul Cellini pitched hit for Ortiz, and Cellini's now out in one pitch. So Danbury Westerners are down to their last out. crowd really into this game now. Here in the ninth, 3-2. It's been a classic baseball game. Probably the best and closest we've seen all season here at Cardine since the fifth game we've brought to you in the NGTN. We'll bring you every home game from now right through to the last game of the playoffs until the LCS begins. Lancey with the pitch. On the inside corner, the called strike to Monaco. Monaco double in the first. Reacher an infield single in the fourth. It was later throw up second base. There's the crowd. They're really excited. The pitch. Swung on and missed strike two. Malacone struck out in the sixth inning. He's 2-for-3 tonight. Josh Lizzy stands to get the win. 3-2 a score. Last half of the night. Two outs. Newport Gulls looking to go have first sole possession of first place. The 0-2 pitch is swung on, hit foul around the plate area. Count remains 0-2. The Westerners and the Gulls tied for first right now in the Indiansville Southern Division. Only one team can walk away from this game with sole possession as the Gulls start a new six games homestand. The pitch. Swing and a miss, strike three, and this one's over. The Newport Gulls defeat the Danbury Westerners 3-2. Josh Lacey gets the win, striking out. Malacone and the Newport Gulls are now 7-3 on the season. They have sole possession of the NECBL Southern Division. Newport Gulls win it tonight, 3-2 the final score. It was a great pitching duel. We saw a couple of great home runs hit by each team. Newport wins it tonight, 3-2 the final score. We'll have a full post-game report next with the totals and the highlights as we continue on the second season of the Newport Gulls Television Network. Well, back here once again at Cardines Field. We're very happy to be joined right now by Brian Jarosinski, designated here tonight for Newport. Brian, thank you for joining us here on the Newport Gulls postgame show.
Good to be here.
Brian, you had an outstanding evening tonight. You went 3-for-3 with a sacrifice fly. You counted for all three runs batted in for the Newport Gulls. How about that game you hit out there tonight?
Well, I mean, I'm just glad I could be the one who was able to, you know, help the team get a W, especially against this team. This team, you know, stopped our, you know, our undefeated season, obviously. And, but like you said, big game for first place. You know, I'm just, and this team's real good. The fact that, you know, someone's not doing good, someone else is, and picking up everyone else. So I'm just glad, you know, tonight was my night. Tomorrow's gonna be someone else's. But, you know, tonight was mine. I was able to get the runs into the team.
The Newport Gulls now do own first place in the NECBL Southern Division. Improved their record to 7-3 tonight against the Danbury Westerners. Now, Danbury is a tough team this year. How do you think you'll fare against the other outings this season?
Against Danbury?
Yeah.
I think we'll do pretty good. I mean, like, we're pretty evenly matched teams. They got good hitters, they got good pitchers, so do we. I mean, we're both good teams, you know, all over the board. So, I mean, they're gonna be good games, you know. They're gonna be games you're gonna want to come out and see. You know, the first two were, you know, extra inning game, and then they got another close game, and like you saw tonight, another, you know, one-run game. So, I mean, they're gonna be battles all season long. That's for sure.
Now, that was a very long home run you hit. It's a 30-foot wall out there in right center field. Did you think that ball would be gone when you hit it off the bat?
Oh, I don't know. I mean, it was iffy. I mean, you always got the wind, you know, swirling around here, obviously, because the water. So, you know, I was just happy. I actually thought it was in the gap just off the bat, and, you know, it got up the wind a little bit and was able to clear the bench. So, you know, two runs for us. And, you know, not too proud about that.
Now you have to get going. One final question for you. How does it feel to be here playing Cardines Field in Newport with the Newport Gulls?
Oh, it's an absolutely great situation. I mean, I've played for, you know, five summer teams throughout in college, and this is by far, they take care of you much better by far than anywhere else I've ever played. It's an absolutely great place to play.
Well, Brian Jarosinski, the Newport Gulls designated here tonight. You're our Newport Gulls player of the game. Thank you for joining us here on the NGTN.
Thank you very much.
Have a good night. We'll have a final word next as we continue on the Newport Gulls Television Network. Well, back here one final time at Cardines Field in Newport. The Newport Gulls defeating the Danbury Westerners 3-2. The final score here tonight. Newport improves to 7-3 overall. They have a tough schedule up ahead as they continue to play many games in a row, their day off throughout the entire month of June. July will be a better month for Newport. It will have 4 days off, even a couple of days off in a row. Newport, of course, just finished playing 9 games straight since opening night and had their first day off yesterday. Come back tonight well-rested and defeat Danbury in an outstanding game, 3-2. Of course, it was a pitching battle all along. Josh Lizzy gets the win, relief pitcher for the Newport Gulls tonight. He pitched 3 scoreless innings of relief. And of course, you just saw our Newport Gold player of the game, Brian Jarosinski, who accounted for all three of Newport Gold's runs tonight with a sacrifice fly to send Blake Church home, as well as a two-run home run in the sixth inning. It was a two-run inning for both teams. And that would be the final score tonight, 3-2, the final. Well, Newport goes back on the road this weekend before returning here to Cardines Field on Monday night and Wednesday and Friday of next week. They'll be playing three home games next week. The second to last week of June, we'll have all three home games for you on the NGTN. I'd like to thank everybody for watching tonight's game. It's one of the best we've taped ever here at Cardines, a real classic baseball matchup. I'd like to thank those who have made our broadcast possible. The executive producer of Newport Gold's Baseball is Steve Andrade. Our director, Tom Lemer. Our audio technician, Ryan Betancourt. On our camera tonight was Chris Salisbury. Our graphics engineer was Ryan Phoenix. And our production assistant and associate producer was Mr. Raymond Ballard, Sr. I'm Nick Lemer, bringing you this game tonight from Cardines Field in Newport. Newport defeats the Danbury Westerners 3-2 in the final and takes sole possession of first place in the New England Collegiate Baseball League Southern Division. I'd like to thank you all for watching. Until our next broadcast, so long, everybody.